I think the biggest mantra that I live by is that you make your own luck.
Unlike a lot of people, you started your career with digital. Mm. You've been in this space for 17 years, which is a lot, yeah. Right? How has the space evolved?
So I would compare 17 years in a normal industry to 17 years in dog years in digital industry. That's how I would say it. So it's about 80 years in a normal industry. Things have evolved like anything. 2001, it was not even an afterthought. Digital was not even a rounding off error in most plans. Now, even if you buy popcorn, you're buying it on a PVR through digital. I mean, who would have thought that in 2001? So that's really how things have evolved. And I think from a marketer's perspective also, earlier, I mean, 2008-2010, digital was, okay, I've got some budgets left, let me think about doing digital, to now where it's intrinsic to everything that they do. I mean, it's not about budgets, it's about saying that, okay, where does digital fit into it? Because this is perhaps the only medium which is a one-on-one and it's interactive, whereas mostly everything is broadcast. So how do you add a layer of interaction to all the broadcast medium, whether it's print or television? Digital needs to have a connect to all of them, because that's the only way a consumer can connect back.
So today, with influencer marketing kind of becoming really important, in your view, which is the most suited way for brands, or the optimum way for brands to leverage this for a sustained long-term impact?
You need to invest in long-term relationships as far as influencer marketing goes. Some brands use it very well, and I was giving this as an example of how, in the overall scheme of things, Nike did that with Colin Kaepernick, huge influencer, both in the as a brand ambassador, but also as an influencer. He's a key influencer that is there, and then they used Serena Williams in the latest ads, and so on and so forth. So you look at, when you're looking at that, the main influencers that are there, you might have one-off campaigns where you are using micro-influencers and all, but when you're looking at the main influencers, have a longer-term strategy. Have people who are going to connect with the brand, not who's going to charge per tweet, but who are actually going to work with you on the brand and create something together. I think that's very important.
So what are some of the trends in this space that marketers need to watch out for?
So I really feel, and that's a personal thought, that screen time, the time that you spend on your mobile phones, is actually going to decrease because of voice.
Okay.
You are going to spend lesser time looking at your screen than you did before, and this is going to happen very quickly over the next 2 years. Increasingly, that's what is going to happen. You are sitting in your car, you'll not be touching your phones, you'll be using an assistant who will, you know, throw up the next song or tell you, or you'll say that I want to go to XYZ and the map will get adjusted. It's all going to be through voice, so you're not going to touch your phone, for example. So voice is going to be a big change. So how, in that kind of changing landscape, are you as a marketer going to be able to capitalize on that? You know, how are you going to be able to reach out to the consumers and make yourself relevant when that person is not even seeing this phone or that device? One of my favorite movies is Minority Report. Tom Cruise enters a store and, you know, based on his past behavior, they throw up what is being consumed. Now, imagine that you're walking into a store and you're walking into a Zara, and Zara customizes your movements within Zara based on your past purchases, and that map is laid out in front of you using augmented reality.
Yeah, that's beautiful.
And that is different for you, different for me, different for anyone else, because that is just a marketing part of it. The application, again, is a lot more on that.
So, Shams, what is the life mantra you live by?
I think the biggest mantra that I live by is that you make your own luck. A lot of people say that, acha, I've been unlucky in what I've done, or you've been lucky in what you've done. Luck is actually a lot of persistence. It's a lot of making the right kind of decisions that are there. And then, yes, there is a little bit of chance that takes over after that. So I really believe that your life, where you're going, is really in your hands. So work smart, work hard, take some chances. They might not pay off, but don't be afraid.